Good morning, children. Welcome back to English virtual class. Now you take out your English practice book. Today we will do the chapter 5, verbs. Before I tell you about the verb, what is a verb, I want to show you some pictures. You have to guess what they are doing, what these children are doing. So can you guess what the first child is doing? You used to do in the morning and evening. Yes, brushing. Second, yes, running. Next child, drinking. And the girl is dancing. And the baby girl is singing. Oh, what this boy is doing? Sleeping. Yes, next girl is driving. And the boy is cutting. And the girl cooking. So children, you have seen these pictures. In all these pictures, these children, they are doing something. So what they are doing? Some action. Some action is going on. Somebody is running, somebody is singing, somebody dancing. So some action is going on. So what is a verb? Verb is an action word. In this chapter, you will learn about the transitive and intransitive verb. Let's do what is a transitive verb. Children, please listen carefully, read all these lines carefully, only then you will be able to understand. Transitive verbs need an object to add meaning to a sentence. It means in a sentence, that the sentence which has object, that is the transitive sentence. But how you will check the object? To check the object in the sentence, to find out the object, you need to ask two question words. What and whom? What is used for non-living thing and whom is used for human being? It means when you have to check the transitive verb, you have to check whether you are getting the answer of what or whom. If you are getting the answer of what and whom in a sentence, it means object is available. Object always comes after verb. For example, I met Raghav. Here, I is subject, met is verb, and Raghav is object. If I say only I met, it's not clear. For that, I have to add Raghav. I met Raghav or I met my friend. It means object is necessary. Met is a verb and object comes after the verb. When there is object after the verb, that is the transitive sentence. As Raghav is a human being, so question word is whom. If I have to make the question, what is the question? To whom I met. The answer is I met Raghav. Second is, she cooked delicious food. Here question is, what did she cook? Because delicious food is a non-living thing. So, means it has object, that is delicious food. If I say she cooked, it's not looking complete sentence. So, she cooked delicious food. So, delicious food is a object and cooked is a verb. Yes. Now come to the intransitive verb. Intransitive verbs are verbs that do not need an object. Transitive verb, they need object. Intransitive verb, they don't need the object to add a meaning to them. So they are independent. For example, the birds fly high in the sky. For this sentence, question is, who flies high in the sky? This shows that it's intransitive verb because here object is not required. So it means this is intransitive verb. Second is, they went to Delhi in winter vacation. For this sentence, question is, where did they go in winter vacation? Because here the questions are, we are not using what or whom for the question. So these are intransitive verb. Let's see some more examples of transitive and intransitive verb. Here, The man killed. I don't think it's a complete word. The hunter shot. It's not a complete sentence. The boy called. It's not. Whom? The man killed whom? The hunter shot whom? The boy called whom? It's not a complete sentence. We want something. Verb is there, subject is there, but object is not there. But this sentence needs object. If I'll add the man killed a mosquito, now it's a complete sentence. The hunter shot a tiger, now it's a complete sentence. The boy called his mother, it's a complete sentence. So here the man, the hunter and the boy, these are subjects. And killed, shot and called, these are the verbs. A mosquito, a tiger and his mother, these are the objects. Without object, the words given were not complete. It was not a complete sentence. So that's why these are called the transitive verb where object is required. Now is about the river flows. We don't require the object here. It's a complete sentence. The sun shines. The birds fly very high. So, in these sentences are complete in themselves. So, no object is required in these sentences. So, these are the intransitive verbs. So, now you come to the chapter verbs. Section 1. Read the following sentences taken from A to Limits of Mind, which you have to read, children. We have not already done a unit where there is a will of my English reader. First sentence is Eklavya saw beautiful chariots. Number 2 is he saw Drona. Number 3 is Eklavya carved a statue of Drona. Now answer the following question. What did Eklavya see? Yes, very easy. Beautiful chariots. Whom did he see? Again very easy. Drona. What did Eklavya carve? A statue of Drona. Very good. Now come to the next page. Worksheet 1. On the basis of the statements given below, answer the questions that follow. First, we will read all these statements. First is, my brother broke the flower vase. Here, if I write only my brother broke, it's not a complete sentence. I have to add something, the flower vase or something else, then it is a complete. It means this is a transitive sentence. The player kicked the football. The player kicked. If I write only the player kicked, it's not complete. The football, if I am adding object, the player is a subject, kicked is a verb and the football is a object. Then it's a complete sentence and it is a transitive verb. Sagarika plucked the flowers. If I say Sagarika plucked, it's not clear. So, I have to add the object, the flowers. So, then it is a transitive verb. The sun gives heat and light. Same here. If we will not add it, the sun gives what? Question is what? So, heat and light, when we add after the verb, object, then it is a transitive verb. Rana loves cars. What does Rana love? Cars. So it means it is giving the answer of what. So it is a transitive verb. I eat fish. I eat fish. Again it is giving the answer of what. So it is a transitive verb. My teacher helps me. If I only say my teacher helps, it's not clear. My teacher helps whom? Me. So, it is giving the answer of whom. So, it is a transitive verb. Pollution harms human beings. Whom? Human being. So, it is also the transitive verb. Now, on the basis of these statements, you have to give the answer of these questions. First is already given. What did the player kick? Very easy. The football. What did Sagarika pluck? The flowers. What does the sun give? Heat and light. What does Rana love? Cars. What do I eat? Fish. Whom does my teacher help? Me. Whom does pollution harm? Human being. You just see, students, all these sentences are starting with the what or whom. They are giving the answer of what and whom. It means these sentences are of transitive verb. The underlined words are called action words. Here you see break, kick, pluck, give, love, eat, help, harm. All these are the action words, means verb. Now come to the next section 2. Read these sentences that are also taken from A2 Limits of Mind unit, where there is a will of my English reader. Underline the action words in these sentences. Now you have to underline the action words. First is, an old man with snowy white hair came out. What action? What he is doing? What action is? Came out. The practice ended. Eklavya went up to Drona with folded hands. Went up and folded. Now worksheet 2. Complete the following sentences using one word only. Only one word you have to add, that is of your choice. First is already given, the dog barks. The dog barks in itself is a complete sentence. It means no need to add object. When we are not adding the object, it means this is an intransitive verb. My brother dash well, plays well. You can write sings well. You can write writes well. So any word you can write, but I am helping you here. Only that's why I have written plays well. The birds fly. You can write something else. So the birds chirp. So it's your choice. The boys sit quietly. You can write eat quietly also. You can write quietly also. That is your choice. The guests came at 5 p.m. The hungry lion rose. You see, children, there is no object in this. We are not getting the answer of what or whom. It means all these are the intransitive verbs. Do you notice any difference in verbs in section 1 and those in section 2? You just see, in section 2, all these sentences, they don't require the object. So they are intransitive verbs, and in the section 1, we require objects, so those are the transitive verbs. Now, in this, I told you about the verbs. Verb in worksheet 1 need an object to complete their meaning, and such verbs are called the transitive verb. An object answers the question, verb plus what or verb plus whom. So you have to check only this thing, ke if you are getting the answer of what and whom from the sentence, it means that is a transitive verb. And transitive verb always, that it means in transitive verb, object comes after the verb. Homework is, do the exercise of worksheet 1 and 2 in your practice book, and you have to learn also. You have to do a lot of practice. You have to watch this video again and again. Only then you will be able to understand this transitive and intransitive verb. Thank you. Bye-bye.